Going back to their roots, good evening. I'm Scott Eisberg. Porter-Gaud grads Khris Middleton and Aaron Nesmith have done a million and one things since playing in the Roundball Classic. It doesn't mean they've forgotten about it, especially since their former coach John Pearson and AAU coach Antoine Saunders are getting the Classic back together. Swinging for the proverbial fences, you've got to take a shot at some home run guests.
Anything they need, they know I'm here for them.
He used to just be Khris. He still is to them, but to everyone else, he's Khris Middleton, sidekick to the Greek freak, NBA All-Star, world champion, Olympic gold medalist. This just his new life.
It's changed a lot at home, but for the better.
You're a champion, you're a gold medalist, and now you've got a two-month-old kid at home. It brings you back down to reality, I'm sure, pretty quickly.
A little bit, but, you know, it's a blessing. To get back home and spend time with him, get to know him, and also my daughter, that's what meant the most to me over the summer.
It all comes full circle. Watch him celebrate the biggest moment of his professional life on a worldwide stage. A shoe-in for the guest list, those high school coaches in tow.
It was definitely a fun night for everybody involved. I was happy, they were able to make it. JP, my folks here, and, a lot of my supporting family here in Charleston. So it was fun to see them celebrate and enjoy the night with us all.
Amazing, a season that ended with a Porter-Gaud contingent on an NBA floor started with one as well.
You know, he was in the NBA when I was still in middle school, so his first he drive me to make it to the NBA, then when I finally make it to the NBA, he got to go win a ring and a gold medal to one-up me again, so now I got even more to strive for to catch up to, so that's now on the bucket list.
For Aaron Nesmith, a first-time summer veteran, the grind is real, not all glitz and golf.
The travel was a lot of fun, being to see a bunch of places I've never been for, learning from a bunch of guys I've looked up to my whole life. So it was an experience, definitely took the lessons I learned with me during this summer, improved on what I needed to improve on.
And they hope this big cyclone circle is completed next year, adding Josiah Jordan James.
He's got to go and handle his business at Tennessee and come up to the league and join me and Khris is something that, we've talked about since we were little, so I just can't wait for it to happen.
The Roundball Rouser, better book a tee time for three.
Two students at Cario Middle School were sent home today for refusing to wear a face covering. CCSD confirmed the number late this afternoon.
And we were there as parents and students gathered armed with the American flag in protest. It's our top trending story, and our Tara Jabor tells us what they want from the school and the district.
Parents and students protested here outside of Cario Middle School today. Many of the parents told me they're upset because their student won't get to learn in the classroom without wearing a mask.
I am not anti-mask. I am about freedom of choice. I am about what my family should do for my children.
All students and staff at CCSD schools must wear a mask until October 15th or be sent home for virtual learning.
This is where they want to be. They want to be in here with their peers. They want to be here interacting, with faculty, with their peers.
Rick Fabrizi has four kids in CCSD schools.
As for my family, we are looking at other options. Homeschooling is definitely one of them.
Other CCSD parents welcome the mask mandate.
Fully support Charleston County School Districts. I think they're absolutely doing the right thing by mandating masking in our schools. I feel like any extra added layer of protection to protect not only the students, but staff, parents, grandparents.
On Monday and Tuesday, students who did not wear a mask were taken to a proctored location for virtual class. A few students we talked with say they felt mistreated by staff.
They can't hear you we can't really hear them. Like today mine froze and I couldn't hear. So every time I was trying to talk to them, they muted us.
When I first joined the Zoom, they said that I said hi and no one even answered. And then I kept saying hi and no one was answering.
We reached out to CCSD about the issue and they said that parents voiced their concerns to administrators and quote, "We will continue to work with our teachers and faculty about the process to provide live virtual learning for every student and family that chooses that option," end quote. Working for you, Tara Jabor, ABC News 4.
And as of 6 p.m., a spokesperson could not provide the total number of students district-wide who were sent home for not wearing masks. Now, we asked South Carolina's Attorney General if the office had gotten complaints about CCSD's mandate and whether the district is violating the proviso is a question of fact that would have to be determined by a court. There's already a state Supreme Court case pending on whether Proviso 1-108 is constitutional. There's also a lawsuit by the ACLU, a class action lawsuit filed by parents in Charleston County. The attorney general said state and federal courts already have this issue before them.
Seeing back in June in Arizona, his case has received renewed interest following the search for Gabby Petito.
And tonight, his family determined to find out what happened to their 24-year-old son. Our Caroline Belchunas spoke with his father today to hear where this case stands.
The Colombian native was reported missing back in June and hasn't been heard from since. A few clues have turned up since then. His family now has a private investigator looking into the case. Daniel Robinson was last seen on June 23rd leaving a job site in a rural part of Arizona where he worked as a geologist. His vehicle was found badly damaged in a ravine several weeks later. Despite search efforts, there's been no sign of the 24-year-old. His father, David Robinson, says police told him they do not suspect foul play. Robinson says their private investigator uncovered evidence that proves otherwise. He says there's been some strange theories. He feels police have given up on the case.
I don't know what happened to my son, but I know what didn't happen to my son. I know my son didn't purposely wreck his vehicle. I know he wasn't driving around in the desert for almost 30 days. Wrecked his vehicle, and I know my son didn't undress himself, and I know my son didn't walk off into the desert looking to, for a monastery to become a monk.
David Robinson has started an online petition urging the Buckeye Police Department to take a closer look at the case. It currently has more than 16,000 signatures. Buckeye police say they have worked with several agencies and have searched 70 square miles in an effort to locate Daniel. Police say they do continue to explore leads and urge anyone with any information to please come forward.